Hello, Grade 8. How are you today? I hope you are fine and safe. In this video, we are going to solve the worksheet about congruent triangles. But let's remember at the beginning how to prove that two triangles are congruent. We said in the previous video lecture that there are two cases of congruent triangles, which are the hypotenuse side and the hypotenuse angle. Okay? And we took some examples and we solved exercises in the worksheet lecture video. In the lecture video about proving congruent triangles by hypotenuse side and hypotenuse angle. These are the main ideas in the lesson. There were only two main ideas. Now, let's start solving exercises from the worksheet. So I'm going to solve here. So, and question number one, construct the following. In part A, we have a triangle ABC is right at B. So we need to draw a triangle ABC which is right at B. Okay, so let me draw a triangle here, right at B. And we call it ABC. Okay, so it's A, B, C. This triangle is right at B, so we have 90 degrees here. Such that AB equal 5 centimeters, so AB equal 5 centimeters, and of course in your copy books you must draw it correctly that AB should be 5 centimeters, and BAC equal 40 degrees. BAC, this angle is 40 degrees. Okay, so you must draw in your copy books like that. Okay, fine. And now I think it's better like this. And now name the hypotenuse in the triangle ABC, then calculate angle ACB. Right. What is the hypotenuse in the triangle ABC? The hypotenuse is, so you should write like this. The hypotenuse, how AC is the hypotenuse, you can write it like this. Okay. And calculate the angle ACB. So in this triangle, so we just write in triangle ABC, okay, we have, ABC plus ACB plus BAC equal 180 degrees. Okay, and angle ABC equal 90, so we write 90 here, plus angle ACB, we just write ACB, plus angle BAC, which is 40, equal 180. Okay, so 90 plus 40 is 130. So we write 130 plus ACB equal 180, and then ACB equal 180 minus 130. يعني هتطلع أنت in 50 degrees. So the angle ACB equal 50 degrees. Okay, so let's write it here. So this angle is 50 degrees. So we have 40 degrees, we have 90 degrees, we have 50 degrees. Make sure this is 90 and this is 90, so it's correct. Part B, so let me solve part B here in blue. Triangle EFG, يعني draw a triangle EFG, okay, such that EFG equal 40 and FEG equal 50 and EF equal 4 centimeters. Okay, so I'll draw another triangle. The another triangle should be like this. EFG equals 40 degrees and FEG equals 50 degrees. Okay, so if you measure these two angles here, 40 plus 50, it's 90. Yani it means that the last angle is also 90, so it's a triangle like this. So let me draw it. Okay, so it is a triangle like that. Let me write it here, draw it here. And it is triangle EFG. Okay, EFG equal 40. So let me write E here and F here and G here. I'll let you know why. Since angle EFG equal 40, so this angle is equal to 40 degrees, and FEG equal 50 degrees, and this angle is 50 degrees. So 40 plus 50, 90. So of course this angle should be 90. And EF equal 4 centimeters. EF equal 4 centimeters. So this angle is okay. So it's fine till now. Let's go calculate EGF in the same way we calculate EGF. So just we write EFG plus EGF plus FEG again equal 180. And then we go EFG equal 40, it's given. Okay, so we write 40 plus EGF. We write EGF plus FEG 50 equal 180. So we do some calculations here. 40 plus 50, 90. So 90 plus EGF equal 180. At the end, it gives that EGF, angle EGF equal 90 degrees. I hope my handwriting is very clear. Okay, did you use the nature of the triangle EFG? Okay, use the nature of the triangle EFG. So triangle EFG is right at G. Okay, so triangle EFG is right. Let me write it from here. Triangle EFG is right at G. It is a right triangle at G. Okay. Part C. Triangle MNP right at M, such that MN equal 4 and MP equal 6. Okay, so just you need to draw a triangle here. Yani this question is just yani some revision about right triangles. Yani for example, here AC is the hypotenuse, EF is the hypotenuse. Okay, it's a right angle triangle. Okay. So in part C here, triangle MNP, so let me take another new paper. So we need to draw a new triangle here. New triangle is this one, which is this one, MNP. Okay, it's right at M. Okay, so it's also a right triangle, such that MN equal 4 and MP equal 6. So in your copy books, you need to draw a right triangle like this. Okay, you need to draw a right triangle like this. This is part C. Okay, So right at M, يعني this is M. Okay, and the name of the triangle is MNP, and such that MN equals 4, MP equals 6. So this is P, and this is 6 centimeter. This is N, and this is 4 centimeter. Okay, it's only like this. Just draw a triangle. In part D, triangle RST, right isosceles of vertex R. So triangle RST. Right isosceles. What do you mean by right isosceles? It's right triangle with two equal sides of vertex R, okay, such that RS equal 5 centimeters. Okay, RS equal 5 centimeters. So let's draw a right isosceles triangle in part D. So in part D, we need to write how to draw a right isosceles triangle, and we keep the sides here equal to each other like this one. Okay, and now we label it by RST of vertex R, and its vertex is R. So we just write R here and S here and P here, whatever, or S here and P here, it's okay. It's a right isosceles triangle, so this angle is 90 and this side equal to this side. And he said that RS equal 5 centimeters, so this is 5 centimeters. And this is also 5 centimeters, just like that, yeah, constructions. Okay, so this exercise, or by this exercise, you made some revision about constructing triangles, and especially right angle triangles, and we need to use them in hypotenuse side and hypotenuse angle, and by proving the congruent triangles. Okay, let's go to exercise number two. Now, question number two. The adjacent figure given two triangles. Okay, given two triangles, ABC and DEF. Okay, ABC and G, E, F. So here it's written by mistake, E, F. I'm so sorry, it's G, E, F. Okay, so this one is G, E, F. Such that EGF equal 90 degrees, yeah, and EFG equal 25. So where is angle EFG? We start from EF. G, so it's this angle. This angle is equal to 25, so just label it 25. ABC equals 65, so ABC equals 65, and BAC equal 25. BAC equal 25 degrees. AB equal EF, AB equal EF, this side equal this side. So we have in this triangle 90, 25, we have this triangle 25, 65. So let's check now. And AB equal EF, okay, AB equal EF, tamam. Show that ABC and EFG are equal triangles, yani are congruent triangles. So let me start by number one. So in order to prove that they are congruent, we must prove that either they are hypotenuse side or hypotenuse angle, since this is our lesson, right? Like, let me find the missing angles here. Or just wait, no need to find the missing angles. But our lesson says that, our idea says that two right triangles are congruent if they are hypotenuse side or hypotenuse angle. Okay, hypotenuse angle or hypotenuse side. But here, do we have a hypotenuse here? Like in triangle EGF, this is the hypotenuse since this angle is 90. So is AB a hypotenuse? So you must ask yourself this question. Is AB a hypotenuse type? To prove that it's hypotenuse, this angle must be 90 degrees. Like, is it 90 degrees? Big question mark. So this is what should we prove now, and then we continue. Okay, so let's find the missing angle here. Okay, in triangle, so let me write here, in triangle ABC. I'm solving it slowly, it's better. We have ABC angle plus BAC plus ACB equal 180, right? Angles in triangle. Right, ABC equals 65, this is given. BAC equal 25, this is given. We still have angle ACB is missing, equal 180. 60, 70, 80, 90. So this angle is 90 plus ACB equal 180. Okay, so it means that ACB angle equal 180 minus 90. You must write all this, so it's equal 90. So ACB equal 90 degrees. It means that this angle is right angle. Okay. We write here, hence, A, our triangle, let me write it well, hence, ABC, our triangle, ABC is right at C, okay? Fine. And here, how could we prove that the two triangles are equal triangles or are congruent triangles? Okay, so we have EF equal AB, okay, given, and they are hypotenuse. Both are hypotenuse. This is the hypotenuse in this triangle, and this is the hypotenuse in the second triangle. We proved that it's right angle, angle C. And also, we have angle EFG equal angle BAC equal 25 degrees. Also, it's given. Hence, the two triangles, or you may write triangle ABC and triangle EFG, triangles, are congruent. It's not sufficient to write congruent. You must write the reason by what hypotenuse angle. So they are congruent by hypotenuse angle. Fine, I think it's clear. Part 2, write the corresponding sides. Okay, so let me write part 2 in blue. Write the corresponding sides. So part 2, yani the corresponding sides, yani the equal sides. Okay, so we have already EF equal AB, so we still have EG equal BC and AC or GF okay equal AC. Okay guys, so I'm solving it slowly and step by step to understand it well. I may solve it faster than this, but of course, it's better to solve it slowly. So here we said E, this is EG equal BC, and we have AC equal GF. Okay, GF equal AC. So let me write them here, this side equal this side, and this side equal this side, AC and GF. Okay, so this question 2 finished, nothing else. Yeah, question 3, Let me make it bigger a little bit. Yeah. EFG is a right isosceles triangle. Everything is written here. EFG is a right isosceles triangle at F. So it's a right isosceles triangle at F. Okay, I think like that it's more clear. So EB equal FG, this is the given. The bisector of angle EFG, the bisector of angle EFG, يلي هو هيدا, this one, this is the bisector. Okay, cuts EG at I, so it cuts EG at I. Okay, so this is the bisector of this angle, which cuts EG at I. Okay, J is a point on FI. This is J, is a point on the bisector, يعني FI. A and B are the orthogonal projections of J on FG and on EF. يعني A is the orthogonal projection of J on FG. يعني this angle is 90, and B is the orthogonal projection of J on EF, so this angle is 90. Okay guys, that's fine. So let's go now by number one. Prove that JAF, where is J? JAF, يعني this triangle, okay, and JFB, يعني this triangle, are congruent triangles. Why they are congruent triangles? أول شيء, let's write in triangle J أو FJA أو JAF. You may write it like this, JAF. Okay, in triangle JAF, what do we have in triangle JAF? We have JF is a hypotenuse. Okay, so it is a hypotenuse. And in triangle BJF, we have JF is a hypotenuse. صح? So both are hypotenuse. طيب. So I have in this triangle, and this triangle, a common hypotenuse. So I still need one angle, but I don't have the measure of any angle here. But I have something here given that FJ is the bisector of the angle EFG. Okay? Is a hypotenuse. And what do we have also? We have angle BFJ angle equal JFA. Okay, I don't have the measure, but I know that they are equal. And BFJ and JFA are equal since le, you should write the reason, since JF is a bisector of angle BFA. Okay, so this is all angle BFA. This is the bisector. Yeah, it means that this angle is equal to this angle. Okay, so let me just high angle equal to this angle. So what do we have here? The two triangles. We have a common side, which is common hypotenuse, which is JF, and angle here equal angle here. Hence, we write at the end. Hence, JAF أو triangle JAF and triangle triangle JBF are congruent by hypotenuse angle. Also, they are congruent here by hypotenuse angle. Okay, number two. Okay, so let's go by, or let's continue by number two. In number two, I write it here. Using another case of congruency, solve part one. Okay, using another case of congruency, solve part one. So let's think about another case of congruency to solve part one. Yani, I need to prove that this triangle and this triangle are congruent by a different way. Okay, fine. So we have many ways to find another way to prove congruent triangles, maybe by side angle side, by side side. So let me try to prove, or let me start from the given, okay, to prove something. Okay, right. In the two triangles IFA and BJF. Okay, how much we have? IF, so let me write here, and triangles BJF and IFA, okay, triangle IFA, we have IF is common. Okay, so this side is a common side. So let me just color it by red. This side is a common side. So what do we still have? We also have JB equal JA. Why JA equal JB? Since they are orthogonal projections from the same, yani from the bisector of the angle, we have JA equal JB orthogonal projections. Okay, they are orthogonal projections. Right. So we have this side equal this side. Right. We still have to prove, again, we still need one angle, which is this one. Okay, ideal angle. So if we prove this angle equal to this angle, so it means that they are equal by side angle side. Right. Is this angle equal to this angle? Let's see how. We have also BFI or BFJ, which is this one, okay, equal JFA. And JBF, which is this one, equal JAF, equal 90, ID given, right? And this is also, only we may write the reason here, JF is bisector, bisector of BFA, and here it's given. Okay, so we may write H1 on a side. Time. Anyway, it's proved. Hence, we have one angle here equal one angle here and one angle equal one angle here. So of course the third angle should be equal to the third angle. This is a rule. So BJF, hence BJF equal the angle BGF equal the angle FJA. Okay. Hence, at the end, triangle BJF and triangle I or JFA, here by mistake it's written IFA, it's J. Triangle JFA. Okay, are congruent by side angle side. Okay, this is the second way to prove that they are congruent by side angle side. So let me solve part 3 here. Okay, this is part. Show that AG equal BE. A G, yani this one, equal BE, yani this one. Okay, how could you prove that? This side equal to this side. Let me erase everything here and continue. So we need to prove that this side equal this side. What do we have from the beginning? We have from the beginning FG equal FE. Why FG equal FE? Since it's given, ليه and why isosceles. Okay, so it was given that they are equal. He said from the beginning, right isosceles triangle at F, EFG. Okay, طيب. And we have FA equal FB. FA equal FB. Why FA equal FB? Proved. Proved from part 2 and part 1. ليه? Since they are congruent. Okay. Hence, at the end, hence, AG equal BE. Okay. That's everything, guys. And I'm sorry for solving very slowly since, يعني, of course, I need to do this. Okay, hala, if you feel that it's very easy to you, there's an option in YouTube, make the video faster by 1.5 and it will go faster. Okay, or you may skip. Thank you and bye bye.